Assalamu alaikum everyone. I welcome in the third lecture on chapter number 3 of Book Sanjil. As you know that we were studying the chapter number 3 of Book Sanjil. The name of the chapter number 3 is Properties of Pure Substance. I continue my lecture from where I left in the last lecture. So let's have a quick recap what we did in the last class. Actually, in the last class we learned to use the property tables by solving different numericals. That is, we solved different numericals, and with the help of those numericals we used property tables for different substances at a given conditions. So I say that we will also be using the property tables in the today's class as well, because as I told you that that property tables are very important, and if you know that how to use the property table, then this thing will be used again and again in the thermodynamics. So we will do the same thing, that we will be using the property tables to solve the numericals. These are the learning outcomes of today's lecture. The first learning outcome is that you will be learning the ideal gas equation of a state. Then you will be learning compressibility factor. First we will study the theory of compressibility factor, then we will learn the compressibility factor with the help of solving few numericals. Then the last topic will be other equations of state. Again, we will learn some theory first and then we will solve few numericals. So these are the learning outcomes. So what is ideal gas equation of state? So any equation that relates the pressure, temperature and specific volume of a substance is called an equation of state. The simplest and best known equation of state for substances in the gas phase is the ideal gas equation of state. Dear students, if you recall that this thing you have already learned many times. I think you learned this thing in the metric physics, and then chemistry as well, and then in the second year as well. So you must be familiar with the ideal gas equation of state. The ideal gas equation of state is PV is equal to RT, and this ideal gas equation predicts the behavior of a gas quite accurately within some properly selected region. So this ideal gas equation of state is very well known. It gives some good results, but it has some limitation, that it gives accurate results in some specified region, which we will study in more detail in the upcoming slides. So PV is equal to RT is the ideal gas equation of state. Here P is the pressure, small v is the specific volume, T is temperature, and R is the gas constant. And R is the gas constant, and gas constant has different values for different gases. That is why it is called the gas constant. And R has a unit of kilojoule per kilogram, and you can get it, the gas constant value, by dividing the universal gas constant by the molecular mass of that particular gas. So if you divide the universal gas constant by the molecular mass of that particular gas, then you will get the gas constant. So students, do memorize the units of the main parameters like R and RU. You must know, you must memorize the units of these important parameters. For example, the gas constant has a unit of kilojoule per kilogram. Universal gas constant has a unit of kilojoule per kilomole Kelvin, and its value is 8.31447 kilojoule per kilomole Kelvin. And universal gas constant has one value is for all the gases, its value does not change. And students, note that if you use R in kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin here, then temperature should be in Kelvin, then and pressure should be in kilopascal, not in pascal, so that you have the of the uniformity of the units and dimension. This thing you learned in the chapter number 1. The ideal gas equation of a state can be written in various forms. So we will recall these forms. You know that mole can be defined as mass per unit molecular mass. So if you divide the mass of a gas by the molecular mass, then you will get the number of moles. So in this book, Sanjil, the number of moles are represented by capital M, capital N, and M is represented by mass is represented by m, small m, and molecular mass is represented by capital M. Here here you can write that m mass will be is equal to molecular mass into number of moles. And this thing you also learned in the chapter number 1, that specific volume is volume divided by mass. Volume per unit mass is specific volume, and volume will be equal to mass times specific volume. So if you replace, so what is the equation? Equation is PV is equal to RT. So here if you replace small v with capital V divided by m, and m here in is dividing, so if you send it to the other side, it will be MRT. So PV is equal to MRT. So PV is equal to MRT is the another form of ideal gas equation of the state. But here you note that V should be in meter cube unit and M should be in kilogram. So PV is equal to MRT, but here V has a unit of meter cube per kilogram. Another form we can write that M into R, M in from equation number 3-12, you can see that M is equal to capital M into N. So M, you can replace the value of M here, M into N R, and N into R is RU and RU. So here MR can be replaced by N into RU. So PV is equal to NRT. N is the number of mole and RU is the universal gas constant. This is the another form. And if you divide volume by number of mole, it will become molar specific volume, V bar, volume per unit mole is the V bar, molar specific volume, and it has a unit of meter cube per kilomole. Then it will become PV bar is equal to RUT. So these are the common forms of the ideal gas equation of states, and this equation of states can be used according to the given conditions. If you have some specific conditions given, if let's suppose if mass is given, volume is given, then you can use this relation. If number of moles is given, universal gas constant, volume, then you can use this relation. So depending on the relation. So for two cases like equation number 3-13, it can be written as PV upon T is equal to MR. M is mass, which is constant, and R no, equation number 3-14 can be written as PV upon T is equal to NRU. N is number of moles and RU is the universal gas constant. So if the number of moles are fixed, then N into RU will become a constant. So P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to constant, P2 V2 upon T2 is equal to constant. So you can compare the both sides, it will become P1 V1 upon T1 is equal to P2 V2 upon T2. This is also a very common form of the ideal gas equation which we can use in the numericals. So the ideal gas equation of a state. So people say that ideal gas does not exist. So there is no such thing that the ideal gas exists in the nature. All the gases are actual gases, real gases, and the ideal gases, as the name says, they do not exist in the real life, but they are the ideal models which the real gases follow in some specified conditions. So what are these conditions? At low pressures, for low densities, the real gases follows the ideal gas behavior. And at what are the conditions to get the low densities? Low densities you can get at low pressure and high temperature. If the pressure is low and temperature is high, the density of a gas will be low. And then you can use the ideal gas equation of a state with quite some good accuracy. But if you have very high pressure or very low temperature, then the real gases does not obey the ideal gas behavior, because what happens that if you increase the pressure, then volume will decrease and if you keep on increasing the pressure, will volume will start decreasing. But it doesn't mean that if you go at a very high pressure, then the volume of the gas becomes zero. It doesn't happen. So at high pressures, similarly, if you start decreasing the temperature, again volume will start decreasing. But it doesn't mean that at very low temperature the volume of the gas becomes zero. It doesn't happen. So at very high pressure and at very low temperature, the gases have high density and they does not obey the ideal gas behavior. So this PV is equal to RT has a limitation that it only applicable at low pressure and high temperatures. So this figure is showing the error. Actually, you can see that this is the TV plot, which we also used in the previous lectures. This is the dome, like these are the compressed liquid, and then this is the saturated liquid vapor mixture region, then this is the superheated region, the superheated vapor region. And these numbers, like these are, this is a percentage error, and the percentage error is volume from table, that is from the property tables, volume, the ideal means volume from ideal gas equation. So like you are taking the values from the tables and you are assuming that the values from the table are the exact values, and the values from the ideal gas, these are the approximated values, then you can, then you have calculated the percentage error. So like these numbers are the percentage error. If this number is zero, it means that the error is zero. So it means that you can approximate the real gas as an ideal gas. So in this region, the shaded region, the value, the numbers are very low, 0, 0, 0.1, 0.2, 0.5. So in this region, we can approximate the, we can use the ideal gas relation. And this region is like, these are the constant pressure lines. This is the constant pressure line of 0, this is 0.1, and this is the 0.8 kilopascal, 10 kilopascal, and 100 kilopascal. So if the pressure is low, this region is low pressure region. In the low pressure region, at pressures below 10 kilopascal, and this table is for water, water vapor can be treated as an ideal gas regardless of its temperature with negligible error, less than 0.1%. In this region, we can approximate water vapor as an ideal gas. But at high pressures, especially in the vicinity of critical region, the error is 56.2, 152.7, 49.5. In this region, the water vapor cannot be treated as an ideal gas. So we can conclude that the question is water vapor an ideal gas? So water vapors can be assumed as an ideal gas only at low pressures. Pressures below 10 kilopascal, below, because at 10 kilopascal this error is very low. But at high pressures, water vapors cannot be treated as an ideal gas. So in air conditioning applications where the pressures are very low, you can assume that water vapors behave as an ideal gas. But in the steam power plants where the pressure is very high, you cannot assume that water vapors are the ideal gas. So you cannot use the ideal gas equation, but it is suggested to use the steam tables in the power plants application where the pressure is high. So this is again the same thing, that at high pressure and at high pressures we cannot use the ideal gas equation. So now what will we do? We just learned that at high pressures the ideal gas equation cannot be used. Then there is a compressibility factor. Compressibility factor is actually a measure of deviation from the ideal gas behavior. So the deviation from the ideal gas behavior can be reduced by using the compressibility factor. So compressibility factor is defined as Z. So PV is equal to RT is the ideal gas equation. So you can see that in the PV is equal to RT, the ideal gas relation, we have multiplied RT with the Z, and Z is the correction factor, which is called compressibility factor. And if Z is equal to 1, then this equation will become again the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to RT, it means that this is the ideal gas. But if Z is greater than 1 or less than 1, it means that these are the real gases. So the correction factor will be greater than 1 or less than 1 for the actual gases. And Z can be found from this formula, V actual volume divided by ideal volume. And an ideal volume can be calculated from the ideal gas equation. So this compressibility factor Z, we can find it from tables. In the book we have tables. But to enter into the table, we need some parameters. These parameters are the reduced pressure, reduced temperature, and the reduced volume. And these reduced pressure can be calculated as if you divide the pressure with the critical pressure. So it will be called reduced pressure. So reduced pressure will have no unit. It's a normalized, a dimensionless number, which you get by dividing the pressure with the critical pressure. Similarly, if you divide the temperature, the given temperature, with the critical temperature, then it will be reduced temperature. And similarly, if you reduce volume, is get by dividing the actual volume with the RT critical, P critical. And the Z factor for all gases is approximately the same at same reduced pressure and temperature. This is called the principle of corresponding state. So this is a recall what we just learned. At very low pressures, all gases approach ideal gas behavior. But at high pressures, that is near the critical point or in the vicinity of the critical point or the saturation regions, there is a non-ideal gas behavior. But at low pressure, this is the low pressure region, the ideal gas behavior can be used with a satisfactory accuracy. Let's solve a numerical. Determine the specific volume of refrigerant 134A vapor at 0.9 MPa and 70 degrees Celsius based on ideal gas equation, the generalized compressibility chart, and data from the table. So you will use three methods to calculate the specific volume of refrigerant 134A vapors, and you have to find also determine the error involved in the first two cases. So the given pressure is 0.9 MPa and 70 degrees Celsius. So this 0.9 MPa looks to be a high pressure. And at high pressure, you know that the ideal gas equation, the part A, we are expecting that the results will not be good. It will have a great percentage of error. The generalized compressibility chart will be reducing this error, and the data from the tables also determine the error involved in the first two cases. So the third C, data from the tables, is the accurate values. So we can assume that the values which we get from the tables are the accurate one, and then with respect to the value which we get from the tables, we will calculate the percentage error. So these numericals are not very difficult. So what you will be doing, first of all, you go into table A1, and for R134A, you just read the values of R, T critical, and P critical. So you have the property table. This is the first table, the first page of table A1, and at the bottom you will see R134A, and just read these values from the table. So let's come to the first part. First we will calculate the volume from the property tables. So from the property tables and this is 134A, this is not steam. So if you remember that for steam, A6 is the table for superheated vapor, and this is R134A, and for R134A the superheated table is A13. So you just go in the table A13 at 70 degrees Celsius and 0.9 MPa, and just read the volume value 0.027413. This is the value which I got from the table, and it can be treated as exact value of V because the values from the table are the accurate ones. Now we calculate the V from the ideal gas equation, and you know that PV is equal to RT, so V will be RT upon P. R we just know from the table, 0.08149. Temperature should be in Kelvin, so 70 plus 273 and divided by P divided by 900 kilopascal. And please note that pressure is given 0.9 megapascal, but here the pressure should be in kilopascal because R is in kilojoule. So then the units will be balanced. So the volume comes out to be 0.03105, and from the table we got 0.027. So 0.027 and 0.03, it's a big difference. So we can calculate the percentage error. D the exact value of volume minus approximated value of volume divided by exact volume mod multiplied by 100. So exact value is from the table 0.027413, the ideal, the approximated value is 0.03105 divided by the exact value, the error comes out to be 13.3%. So the ideal gas equation, the ideal gas equation is giving an error of 13.3% at pressure of 0.9 megapascal. So this shows that the ideal gas equation cannot be used at high pressures. Now let, this is the table A1. I have shown you that from table A1 you can get the values of R, T critical and pre-critical. And this is table A13, because from this is the table A13, and A13 at 70 degrees Celsius and 0.9 megapascal, you just read the value of V. Now we will find the volume from the compressibility chart. From compressibility chart, you need to know the PR and TR. So PR will be P divided by P critical. P is given 0.9 megapascal, and P critical you found it from the table A1. PR comes out to be 0.22 and TR comes out to be 0.92. Now at PR and TR, you must read the value of Z, and the value of compressibility chart is figure 8A28. So you just remember these values, PR is 0.22 and TR is 0.92. So this is the compressibility chart. Now you have to find intersection point of PR is equal to 0.22 line and TR is equal to 0.92. So you can see that on x-axis we have PR, so this is 0.1, 0.2, and between 0.1 and 0.2 there are 10 boxes, so one box will be of 0.01. So this is 0.2, 0.21 and 0.22. So at PR is equal to 0.2, I draw a line. With the help of scale you can draw this line. Now you can see that these lines, this is TR is equal to 1. This is TR is equal to 1 line. This is TR is equal to 1.05 line. This is going on the left side. TR 1.1, TR 1.15, 1.2. But we are looking for TR is equal to 0.92. So 1.95.9. So we do not have the line of 0.92. So 0.92 line will be between 0.9 and 0.95. So here you can see I have just taken slightly upward, so by assuming 0.92, so this is, so PR is equal to 0.22 line, cutting the line of TR is equal to 0.92, and then I draw a horizontal line towards the y-axis. Here on y-axis this is Z, and Z comes out to be, this is 0.9, one box below, so this is Z is equal to 0.89. so in this way you get the Z value. So once you know the Z, now Z is equal to V upon V ideal. V ideal is the ideal volume from the ideal gas, 0.89 into ideal gas equation volume, and this comes out to be 0.0277. So you can see that actually you are multiplying a correction factor of 0.89 to the volume which you got from the ideal gas equation, and now it looks very close to the value which we got from the table. That from the table we got 0.027, and from the compressibility chart we got 0.02776. So the percentage error comes out to be 1.3%. So now error is reduced from 13.3% to 1.3% if you use the compressibility factor. Okay, now we will solve another numerical, 3-90 of Book's engine. In this numerical, 0.016773 meter cube tank contains 1 kilogram of refrigerant 134A at 110 degrees Celsius. Determine the pressure of the refrigerant using the ideal gas equation, the generalized compressibility chart, and the refrigerant tables. So this is a similar numerical, but the difference is that in the last numerical, pressure and temperature were given and specific volume was required, but now in this case volume is given and temperature is given, and you have to find the pressure. This is the difference. and you have to do the same thing, that you will find the pressure with the ideal gas equation, which is expected that it will give some error, because we have learned that the ideal gas equation gives error at high pressures. B, we will use the generalized compressibility chart, and we have seen that with the help of the correction factor Z, that is the compressibility factor, the error is reduced. And then the third one is the refrigerant tables, and the refrigerant tables they give the exact values. They do not have the errors, because these calculations are done with the help of correct relations and integration and calculation methods. So they do not have the error. The property tables are always list the correct values. So ideal gas equation and the generalized compressibility chart, they do have the some error. So pressure is required, temperature is given, volume is given. So since mass is 1 kilogram, so I took it specific volume is 0.016773 meter cube per kilogram. So doesn't make sense. So it doesn't matter, right? It's because mass is 1 kilogram, so 0.016773 divided by 1, it will be 0.016773 meter cube per kilogram. So we do from table A1 for R134A, we read the values of R, T critical and P critical, like we did in the last numerical. First we calculate the pressure from the property table. This is a typo mistake. It should be P. It should not be specific volume. It should be P. So from superheated vapor table of R134A, this is table A13 at 110 degree Celsius and specific volume of 0.016773. If I show you the table, this is the table A13, and I find the intersection of temperature 110 degree Celsius and volume 0.016773, the cross section of these two values at pressure of 1.6 megapascal, that is pressure is equal to 1600 kilopascal. If you start looking this intersection from start, you will see that in the initial values in table A13, you will not even find the temperature value 110 degrees Celsius. So you have to go down. Initially the volume will also be very high value, so you have to go down, and then you have to find the section of the table where you have 0.016773 volume and the intersection of temperature 110. So this is happening at 1.6 megapascal, and 1.6 megapascal is 1600 kilopascal. So this is the exact value. This is the exact value of the pressure. Now we calculate the value from the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to RT, so P will be RT upon V. We put the value of R, temperature in Kelvin, and specific volume, and the pressure comes out to be 1861 kilopascal, and it's quite different. So as compared to 1600 kilopascal, 1861 kilopascal is a quite higher value. So as expected, the ideal gas equation is giving error. So percentage error is not required in this question, but you can calculate the percentage error by taking the exact value 1600 kilopascal and the approximated value 1861, then you will see that how much is the error. Now let's use the compressibility chart. To enter into the compressibility chart, you need the reduce values. Since temperature is given and volume is given, so you will calculate the reduced temperature and reduced volume. The formulas we discussed in the theory section. So TR is equal to T upon T critical. T is given. T critical is from table A1. TR is 1.023, and VR is this formula. We will put the values and we get VR is equal to 2.24. Now we have to go into the compressibility table, that is A28, and we have to find the intersection of 1.023 TR is equal to 1.023 line and VR is equal to 2.24 line, and we have to read the P reduce value. So this is the compressibility chart. So these solid lines these solid lines are TR lines. So TR is 1, TR is 1.05, TR is 1.10, TR 0.95. So we have to look TR 1.023. So we just take it equal to 1. So TR 1, because 1.023 is approximately equal to TR equal to 1. Now we have to find the VR line. So these dotted lines are VR lines. This is VR 0.07, 0.8, 0.9, 1, 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, and we have to look VR 2.24, 1.6, 1.8, 2.2. So this is 2.2. 2.2 and 2.4. So 2.24 will be in between 2.20 and 2.4. We can get take a slightly upper line near to the 2.20 line. Here you can see. So this solid line and this dotted line, they are cutting each other at this point. You can see at this point, and at this point, at the intersection point, I have drawn the vertical line on x-axis, because on x-axis we have PR. So this is 0.4 and one box earlier. So this will be 0.39. So we got PR is equal to 0.39. So once we know PR, so PR is equal to P upon P critical. PR is, we just read it from the table. P critical is, we read it from the table A1, and we can get P. So P is coming out to be 1583 kilopascal, which is quite near to the value from the table. Table is giving the value of 1600 kilopascal, and the compressibility chart is giving the value of 1583, which is quite close to the exact value. And if you calculate the percentage error will also come out to be very low as compared to the ideal gas equation value of 1861. Okay. So in the previous, we have just learned that the ideal gas equation is a well known equation, but it gives errors in the high pressure and low temperature regions. So apart from the ideal gas equations, other equations are also have also been proposed by several researchers in the open literature. These are the van der Waal equation, Bethe-Bridgman equation, Benedict-Webb-Rowan equation. So we will study these equations. So van der Waal equation. Van der Waal equation is, instead of PV is equal to RT, the van der Waal equation is P plus A upon V square, V minus B is equal to RT. So what van der Waal did? Van der Waal actually considered two additional factors in his equation. He considered the intermolecular forces, and he also considered the volume occupied by the gas molecules. Van der Waal explained that since gas molecules are always in motion, and they are always colliding with each other, and when they collide with each other, they exert forces, and because of these forces, the pressure should be increased. So normally what we do, we take the pressure of the container as a pressure of the gas, but van der Waal said no, the pressure should be increased because of the intermolecular forces. So he said we should add some factor in the pressure, P plus A upon V square. So A is the factor which is taking into account the intermolecular forces. Secondly, then V minus B. So van der Waal said that normally we take the volume of the container as the volume of the gas, but van der Waal said no, we should because the volume molecules of the gases, they also occupy some volume, so we should subtract the volume occupied by the molecules, then we will get the actual volume. So V should be V minus B. So this is the van der Waal equation. These factors A and B can be calculated by these expressions given by van der Waal, and as you can see, these are depending on the critical values, T critical, P critical and R. If you know these values, then you can calculate A and B, and T critical, P critical and R values, you can get it from table A1 for different gases. This then the other equation of state is the Batty-Bridgman equation of state. The Batty-Bridgman proposed this equation in 1928, and it looks quite complex, but it gives quite accurate results as compared to the van der Waal equation and the ideal gas equation of state. In this equation, we have some constants A and B. A and B can be calculated by these expressions. A and B have further constants A0, P0, A and B. And remember, these A and B are different from the van der Waal equation. These constants, you can read it from the table 3-4. So this is table 3-4 in book Sengel. So on table 3-4, you can see that air, argon, helium, nitrogen, oxygen values are listed, and A0, A, B0, B and C values, you can read it from this table. The other equation of state is Weber-Rubin equation. It's a quite big equation and quite complex, but it gives very good results. So we will use these equations in this numerical. So this is 3-96. 3.27 meter cube tank contains 100 kilogram of nitrogen at 175 Kelvin. So volume is given, mass is given, temperature is given. Determine the pressure in the tank. So we need to find the pressure using ideal gas equation, van der Waal equation and Batty-Bridgman equation. Compare your results with the actual value of 1505 kilopascal. The exact value is given and we have to compare the values as well. We have to find the percentage error. So what we do, we go in the table A1 for nitrogen. We read R value, T critical, P critical and molecular mass, because we need these values in the later part. First we calculate the specific volume, because total volume is given in meter cube. So if we divide the volume by mass is 100 kilogram, we get the specific volume 3.27 divided by 100, 0.0327 meter cube per kilogram. This is the specific volume. Now let's calculate the pressure from the ideal gas equation. PV is equal to RT. P will be equal to RT upon V. R value, T value and V value we all know. We just put it and we get the pressure 1588. And if we compare with the exact value of 1505, it's quite higher. So as expected, the ideal gas equation is giving error, because 1505 is a high pressure and the ideal gas equation is giving an error of 5.5%. Now we calculate pressure from the van der Waal equation. For van der Waal equation, we need small a, small b. These are the formulas. We just put it the value and I got a is equal to 0.175, b is equal to 0.00138, p is equal to rt upon v minus b, a minus a upon v square. This is the van der Waal equation and pressure is coming out to be 1495. And 1495 is quite close to the exact value of 1505. So van der Waal equation is giving an error of only 0.7%. So van der Waal equation is much better than the ideal gas equation. Ideal gas equation is giving an error of 5.5%. Van der Waal equation giving an error of 0.7%. Now we come to the Batty-Bridgman equation. For Batty-Bridgman equation, we need to read the values from table 3-3. Value of A, value of B, small a, small b, small c, molar volume. We get multiplying the molecular mass with the specific volume. And we get it. We get the value like this. We put the values into these formulas. A, we get A, capital A, capital B. And then just put it in the equation and we get the pressure 1504, and 1504 is quite close to the 1505 and the error is coming out to be 0.07%, only 0.07%. So Batty-Bridgman equation is much better than the both van der Waal and ideal gas equation. But if you consider that the ideal gas equation is very simple, We do not need to perform too much calculation and it still is giving 5.5% error. But the van der Waal equation, we need to do a lot of calculation. There is a possibility of calculation error as well. and it's giving 0.7%. Betty Bridgman equation is also very complex, so you have to compromise. Ideal gas equation is simple, but it's giving error. The other equations of the state are complex, and they need more calculations than the ideal gas equation of the state. So this is table 3-4, from where we read the values of A0, A, B0, B and C. Okay, so with this we end chapter number 3 of book Sanjil. In the upcoming lectures we will start chapter number 4 of book Sanjil. Chapter number 4 is dealing the law of conservation of energy, that is the first law of thermodynamics, and we will apply the law of conservation of energy to the closed systems. We will consider many closed systems and we will apply the law of conservation of energy. This is called energy analysis of closed system, and then later we will do the energy analysis of the open system. So you have learned the open system and closed system in chapter number 1, and in the upcoming chapters we will do some more intense calculations in the upcoming chapters. So this is the end of chapter number 3. Let's recall some basic concepts which we have learned. The main thing which you must remember that they are compressed liquid, saturated liquid vapor mixture, and there are superheated vapor states. So these are the states which exist during the phase change process, and these states have different properties and different you have to use different property tables to calculate the properties of when some properties are given. Let's suppose if you are in the compressed liquid state, then some properties are given, then you have to use some specified table A7 and A4. A7 is the exact table and A4 you can use an approximation. So the main thing is that you need to know that how can you find the state of a system, then you can use the concerned property table for that chapter. So with this I end here. And in the Google Classroom I will soon upload the assignment and the selected numericals of this chapter. You have to solve these numericals and then you have to submit it back, and there will be a deadline for the assignment which will be communicated to you later on through the WhatsApp group or the Google Classroom. I recommend you that you must attend these numericals. So you have to do the lecture numericals. Just go through the lecture numericals first, and then in the book Sanjil. Book Sanjil is a very good book. So in the book Sanjil, you will find the plenty of already solved examples. So you should go through these solved examples, and then you must attempt the assignment numericals. This will give you a confidence that you have learned the way. You have learned how to use the property tables, and then because most of the time we give the problems from the assignment in the final exams as well. So these assignment numericals are very very important. So with this I say you Allah Hafiz, and see you next time, and I hope you have learned something new from this lecture. So Allah Hafiz, see you next time.